We are back with Senators John McCain and Lindsey Graham. Let me start off both of you on the subject of Afghanistan. We are now in a situation where the U.S. does not want its personnel in ministry buildings of the very government that we're working with, the Karzai government, because we think it's not safe for U.S. military personnel. How does that bode for these agreements that we need to get with Karzai in order for U.S. forces to begin moving out? Senator Graham.
Well, the strategic partnership agreement that we're trying to negotiate with the Afghan government is very important. It's the last card to be played. What we're trying to do is have an enduring political, economic, and military relationship. The hope is after 2014 to have somewhere around 20,000 troops, several air bases with special forces units and air power, so the Taliban can be permanently defeated. The Afghan security forces will always have the help of the U.S. American military to ensure that Afghanistan never fails. This episode with the Koran burning is terrible to watch. Ambassador Crocker has got it right. Keep your eye on the ball. It is very sad that four Americans would lose their lives because of an inadvertent burning of the Quran. I do my reserve duty in that prison, Candy. There is a lot of sensitivity to the Islamic religion, but it is a dangerous place. There are a lot of, they're not choir boys being held there. And Karzai, President Karzai, is insisting that we turn over all 3,044 prisoners to the Afghan legal system as part of the strategic partnership agreement. I cannot agree to that. The legal system in Afghanistan is very immature and porous. And he's also insisting we stop night raids. We're putting Afghans in the lead in night raids, but that's how we're capturing and killing these people. It's a very successful military operation. General Allen says continue night raids. So I will be backing up Allen. We're not going to turn over everybody in that prison to the Afghans at this moment. They're not ready for that, but we need a strategic partnership agreement. And this Quran burning shows the world in which we live, a world in 2012 where people can lose their lives because of an inadvertent burning of a holy document. And things have to change in the Mideast.
Senator McCain, though, looking at it, I think most Americans sort of, as I asked Ambassador Crocker, they wake up and there's this inadvertent burning of the Quran by U.S. personnel on the base. And then there are riots and protests, violent protests for 6 days, and two Americans are murdered inside the interior building. Can you see why Americans go speed up this withdrawal and let's get the heck out? It's been $500 billion, 2,000 lives, and 11 years. Like, when is enough enough?
I can certainly understand the anger and frustration and sorrow that the American people feel. And this is a terribly unfortunate situation there. I also think we have to take the long view, and that is that a strategic partnership agreement, by the way, the original idea for that was Senator Graham's, is the way that we can leave Afghanistan, but in a secure environment and a chance for a democratic government to remain in power. Look, they just saw the United States leave Iraq completely and Iraq unraveling. If we'd had a strategic partnership agreement there and a residual force, which this president did not want, things would be a lot different. They watch what happens in the Middle East and they're starting to make their own arrangements because they have to remain in the neighborhood. And we still continue to have this very looming problem that Ambassador Crocker pointed out, and that is sanctuary in Pakistan for the Haqqani network, Taliban and others. But have no doubt that if Afghanistan reverts to a chaotic situation, you will see Al-Qaeda come back and it again be a base eventually of attacks on the United States of America.
I have two more countries I want to cover here, if I can, a couple of minutes we have left. Senator Graham, first to you, I want to talk about Egypt, which is not allowing, I think, about seven Americans to get out of there because Egypt, the Egypt military government has wanted to try them. These are NGO folks, non-government organization, including Secretary LaHood's son. Mm-hmm. When will this come to some fruition? And the administration says, we're talking. When is this over?
Well, I'm hope it will be over soon. They're being charged under an NGO law, a holdover law from the Mubarak administration that kind of clamped down on any efforts to spread democracy. The Army did not bring this case. It was brought in the judiciary, and it's a politically motivated case with no foundation at all. The NGOs have done a great job over there helping the Egyptian people. But here was the breakthrough on the ground. Senator McCain and myself and our delegation met with the Muslim Brotherhood. They got a large number of votes. They're going to be conservative Islamists. We'll judge them by what they do, not by what they say. But here's what they did do. While we were there, they issued a statement condemning the NGO law, promised to reform it in the future, and that was a very positive sign because the Muslim Brotherhood, the largest bloc in the new parliament, basically said they don't like this law, they think it is unjust and unfair, and they want to change it. That should give everybody the political cover they need to let our people come home.
Senator McCain, I've got 30 seconds left. I wanted to ask you about Benjamin Netanyahu, who is coming over here next week. And I'm wondering whether you believe that the relationship between President Obama and Prime Minister Netanyahu is complicating the U.S. longstanding relationship with Israel.
I think so, and I think the Prime Minister has every reason to be upset. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff that calls Iran a rational country and the American and the National Security Advisor go to Israel and then leak that they are trying to urge the Israelis not to attack Iran. That clearly weakens the Israelis' position vis-a-vis Iran and in the region where they have numerous enemies dedicated to wiping them off the map.
Okay.
So I can understand why relations are in very bad shape right now.
Thank you so much, Senator John McCain, Senator Lindsey Graham.